cannot give you back your homes or restore your dead to life, but perhaps I can give you justice in the name of our king.
Jealous of Rob my whole life. The way my father looked at him, I wanted that. He was better than me at everything. Fighting and hunting and riding and girls. I wanted to hate him, but I never could.
Sometimes I want to hate you. Better than me at everything. Reading.
Okay, so I have heard about the theory that Samwell Tarly may just be the narrator of the storyline behind Game of Thrones. It is a compelling belief, the idea that one of the most lovable characters in the fantasy could actually be the teller of this complex story. As one of the most well-read characters, Sam seems like he would be the one, if anyone, to write the history of this time period. The theory has a few different interpretations, but I'm going to give my view of it the best I can. So right off the bat, Game of Thrones comes from the book series A Song of Ice and Fire by George R.R. Martin. The series is still in its continuation, and it has inspired companion books to be published along the way, including The Lands of Ice and Fire, which includes detailed maps of the regions in the known world, and also The World of Ice and Fire, which is a history book of the fantasy world written from the point of view of a maester in the Citadel. This book is very important in my take on this theory because it has a bias in the favor of House Lannister, and it looks down on both the Starks and the Baratheons due to the intimidating effect the Lannisters have on this maester. This is why it gets really interesting, because since the history book is written with bias and some of the facts may be stretched in favor of one house, it opens up the discussion that other texts could just as well be biased. Like the series A Song of Ice and Fire, for example. As a reader, you engage yourself in the book with the idea that the author, George R.R. Martin, is laying out his story for you to enjoy, but taking in consideration this theory of Samwell Tarly being the one who wrote these events makes us think that he may have written in some bias, like how there's not a bad thing really to say about Jon Snow. He's pretty much the poster boy for Westeros, a great warrior, an even better leader, and a very honorable man, much like the late Eddard Stark. Yet, we never see the Boltons in a good light, or the Lannisters, which are big enemies of the Starks of Winterfell, whose team Sam would definitely be on. You could argue that of course the Starks are viewed as the good guys in the story because they are the main family represented. Daenerys has an equal importance to the narrative, but she is only an individual while we have big storylines for all of the living Starks. A Song of Ice and Fire, the title of the series, could easily be an extra Easter egg towards the validity of this theory. For example, we know that The World of Ice and Fire is a book that actually lives on in the fantasy written for the occupant of the Iron Throne, to catch up on any history of the world that the ruler may need to know. Fans believe A Song of Ice and Fire may very well be a physical book that you can find in the Citadel, written by a wise Maester Samwell further into the future of what we are currently watching and reading. Just imagine the end of the Game of Thrones series. The final books have been written and season 8 is over. Most likely we would have seen what happened at the culmination of events leading to the War of the Dead versus the Living. We had also learned who rules the Seven Kingdoms at the end of it, if anyone. Maybe the Seven Kingdoms were destroyed, or the people of Westeros barely defeated Winter and all its monsters. People would probably band together, trying to rebuild, trying to make the world right again, just like what happened after the original War for the Dawn. And a surviving Samwell Tarly would be living it up in Old Town or Castle Black with his love Gilly and a much older baby Sam. He decides to write about the events of the past in an attempt to ensure the world doesn't forget where it came from, as to not repeat the events of history. Sam knows more than the next person that reading and learning the knowledge in books is a very smart path to sustainability in the world. Just imagine if the average person, if even able to read, flipped through the pages of the books littered throughout the known world. All of the secrets and ancient practices lost through time could be at the fingertips of the people of Westeros and Essos. Have you ever thought about the major power players working the game behind the scenes? Varys, Littlefinger, Tyrion, and even the Maesters. They all share the same source of power through knowledge. When I look at Sam's character in the story and his purpose, I feel like he is there to remind the audience that these people are actually vulnerable. That no matter a character's uniqueness or special features, every person can fall just as hard as the next. Sam isn't known to be super courageous, but yet he fights for what he believes in, just like real people outside of a fantasy series. I really enjoy the concept of Sam being the narrator of the story. He seems to be someone who would want to write about it if he was to survive the rest of the events before the story ends. Let me know your thoughts on the matter. Thanks for watching, everyone. Have a great day. Take care, and I will see you tomorrow.